وبعد. Yesterday we talked about what did we talk about yesterday? صلاة الفجر. What is the ayah that we talked about in صلاة الفجر? Nobody remembers? أحسنت بارك الله فيك. ومن أحسن قولا ممن دعا إلى الله وعمل صالحا وقال إنني من المسلمين. Nobody is better than a person, you know, who said, who made دعوة to Allah عز وجل, and they practice what they do. They invite people to what they responded to Allah. They respond to Allah first. They invite people to what they responded to Allah عز وجل with, and they use their عمل. They lead by action. Allah عز وجل says in the ayah next to that, وَلَا تَسْتَوِي الْحَسَنَةُ وَلَا السَّيِّئَةُ اِدْفَعْ بِالَّتِي هِيَ أَحْسَنُ فَإِذَا الَّذِي بَيْنَكَ وَبَيْنَهُ عَدَاوَةٌ كَأَنَّهُ وَلِيٌّ حَمِيمٌ وَمَا يُلَقَّاهَا إِلَّا الَّذِينَ صَبَرُوا وَمَا يُلَقَّاهَا إِلَّا ذُو حَظٍ عَظِيمٌ. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said the hasana, the good deed, will never be equal to that deed. They're not equal. وما يستوي الأعمى والبصير ولا الظلمات ولا النور ولا الظل ولا الحرور ولا يستوي الأحياء ولا الأموات. يعني the life and the death, they're not the same. Life and death, they're not the same. A person who's alive and a person who's dead is not the same. The dark is not like the light. Jahl or ignorance is not like knowledge. Islam is not like kufr. Always you will find these oppositions in the Quran. Comparison. So that's a standard here. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us a standard, then He gives us an action plan. First you have to establish a standard. And that's the issue with the Muslim community, with us individually, with the family and all that. Sometimes we expect things from each other, but we don't have a standard. No standard. So you look at me or I look at you, there are things I like and things that I dislike. And the same things, there are things you like and things you, but based on what? Based on what? What is the standard? Based on what? What we like and what we don't like. We're in a masjid now. We're in the community now. I'm leading you in salah and you are following. I'm giving you a lecture and you're listening. Right? So, for sure, there will be things that we like and things that we dislike about each other. Sahih? But what is the standard of liking and disliking? Yeah? You see, the standard is what Allah Azza wa Jal put, حب في الله والبغض في الله, or a standard according to hawa and the desire. I like something in my head, and you did not deliver, so I don't like you. Right? وَلَا تَسْتَوِ الْحَسَنَةُ وَلَا السَّيِّئَةُ. That's a standard here. Allah Azza wa Jal said, حَسَنَة according to Allah, سَيِّئَة according to Allah. It is not حسن and سيئة according to me and you. One person one time came to Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم. You know سورة الحجرات, سورة الحجرات. You know the people came and they started calling, Ya Muhammad, come for us. You know, let's talk and let's see your poetry and your khitabah and all of this. So one of them, he said, Ya Muhammad, إن مدحي زين وإن ذمي شين. يعني whomever I praise, he's good. And whoever I criticize, he is doomed. So Rasulullah said, that's Allah. Yani this is Allah Azza wa Jal. Yani Allah Azza wa Jal is the one that whom he likes, he's done, he's good. And whom he dislikes, is doomed. This is Rabbul Alameen only, it's not you. You get the idea, right? So who are you to say that I am? If I praise someone, he is the one. And if I put someone down, he's down. Who are you? Right? So, وَلَا تَسْتَوِي الْحَسَنَةُ وَلَا السَّيِّئَةُ according to who? Yes. Then, this حَسَنَة and سَيِّئَة here, as I said, there's a context here. إِنَّ الَّذِينَ قَالُوا رَبُّنَ اللَّهُ ثُمَّ اسْتَقَامُوا. This is حَسَنَة here. Those good, not going to be equal, those who said, Allah is our Lord, and they stay straight. This is a حَسَنَة. This is a good deed. Before that, in Surah Fussilah, the kuffar said, وَقَالُوا لَا تَسْمَعُوا لَهَذَا الْقُرْآنِ. وَقَالَ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا لَا تَسْمَعُوا لَهَذَا الْقُرْآنِ وَالْغَوْ فِيهِ. يعني they say to each other, don't listen to this Qur'an and just make noise. So people don't listen to Muhammad Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم. That is a سيئة. Are they equal? Are they equal? So yesterday we were talking about the person who's giving da'wah to Allah. Would that person be equal to someone who is opposing the da'wah of Allah? No. Someone who is trying to make the jama'ah together is like someone who trying to divide? Say yes or no?
No.
So someone is eager for the deen of Allah to spread is like someone just trying to fit in and trying to compromise? No. So وَلَا تَسْتَوِي الْحَسَنَةُ وَلَا السَّيِّئَةُ. We just set the standard, right? And I give you a few examples, and I'm sure you can build on. You can build on that. This is not equal to that. So in the surah here, those who don't want to listen to the Quran, not only don't want to listen to the Quran, they don't want anyone to listen to the Quran, and they want to make sure that the message reaches distorted. وَالْغَوْفِي. So this is one group. The other group, قَالُوا رَبُّنَا اللَّهُ ثُمَّ اسْتَقَامُوا مِمَّنْ دَعَى إِلَى اللَّهِ وَعَمِلَ صَالِحًا وَقَالَ إِنَّنِي مِنَ الْمُسْلِمِينَ. That's the other group. They said Allah Azza wa Jalla is our Lord, and they invite people to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So under this category, you can have too many things in our life now. You can have too many things. Those who make it easy and those who make it hard. Those who bring in and those who push away. Those who are, welcoming and those who are not. Those who are rigid and those who are soft. You can find out. Make a big list, mashallah. وَلَا تَسْتَوِي الْحَسَنَةُ وَلَا سَيِّئَةُ. That's the standard. Then Allah Azza wa Jalla giving Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam an order. And his order to all of us. اِدْفَعْ بِالَّتِي هِيَ أَحْسَن. اِدْفَعْ بِالَّتِي هِيَ أَحْسَن. السَّيِّئَةُ. اِدْفَعْ بِالَّتِي هِيَ أَحْسَنُ السَّيِّئَةُ. يعني السَّيِّئَةُ here is the bad deed. And you need to push it away. Push it away with what? بالذي هي أحسن. بالحسن. You have a block of bad preventing you from moving forward. This is a blockage in front of you. There is a wall, brick wall of bad. سيئة. How you push this away? بالذي هي أحسن. With good manners. With good manners. You know, many of the Mufassirin, they said, this means with the salam. With the salam, you know, say salam. And the people who used to make jahl to Rasulullah, وَالَّذِينَ إِذَا خَطَبَهُمُ الْجَاهِلُونَ قَالُوا. So that's السيئة, خَطَبَهُمُ الْجَاهِلُونَ. بِالَّتِي هِيَ أَحْسَن, سلام. He said, so, وَقُولُوا لِلنَّاسِ حُسْنَا. Another قراءة, وَقُولُوا لِلنَّاسِ حَسَنَا. You know, always say the good things. So, you know, you always say the good words. يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا اتَّقُوا اللَّهَ وَقُولُوا قَوْلًا سَدِيدًا. Always you say the good things, the right things to people. And once this becomes a habit, subhanAllah, then you cannot actually say anything bad. And there is a narration, we're not talking about its authenticity now, there's a narration. The Imam al-Tabari mentioned in his tafsir, Qatada, the student of Abdullah ibn Abbas, he said that Rasulullah was sitting with Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiallahu anhu, and somebody insulted Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu. Insulted him. Say something bad to him. And this happened a few times actually. But this time, Abu Bakr did not say anything. فَصَبَرَ عَلَيْهِ سَاعَةً. And he's quiet. And Rasulullah didn't say anything. So the man, you know, argued with Abu Bakr and he told him something bad. So Abu Bakr was quiet. Rasulullah was quiet. And that's it. The man, when he's leaving, Abu Bakr, you know, his nafs moved. Yeah. So he responded to the man. So Rasulullah moved away and stood up and moved. So Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu went behind him. Said, "Ya Rasulullah, the man insulted me and did not say anything. And when I take my right, you went away." He said, "There was an angel actually responding on your behalf. Once you responded, shaitan came. I cannot sit when the shaitan is there." Right? Tawan, there is, as I said, yani, there's a narration there. But the moral of it is, sometimes it is raising your rank to hold your anger. That's why Allah Azza wa Jalla said, "There's not everybody." وَمَا يُلَقَّاهَا إِلَّا الَّذِينَ صَبَرُوا. You have the right to respond. لَا يُحِبُّ اللَّهُ الْجَهْرَ بِالسُّوءِ مِنَ الْقَوْلِ إِلَّا مَنْ ظُلِمْ وَلَمَنْ انْتَصَرَ بَعْدَ ظُلْمِهِ فَأُولَئِكَ مَا عَلَيْهِمْ مِنْ سَبِيلٍ. No problem to take your right in a nice way, not in a foul manner or anything like that. But if you hold, subhanallah. وَلَمَنْ صَبَرَ وَغَفَرَ إِنَّ ذَلِكَ لَمِنْ عَزْمِ الْأُمُورِ. It is something great. يعني Allah Azza wa Jalla did not put like a certain reward for it. It's open. That if you hold your anger and if you don't respond, subhanAllah. So Allah Azza wa Jalla here to train Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. They give you sayyah, you give them hasana. SubhanAllah. You know, someone give you sayyah and your currency is the hasana. You know, one of the Zayn al-Abidin ibn Ali ibn al-Hasan ibn Ali ibn Abi Talib, يعني the grand great grandson of Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, was known for his wealth and for his generosity, and he was known also for his hilm, for his like patience. And one time he is out of the city and coming in, so someone went behind him and started insulting him badly. Into that, this, like this, like this, like this. And he is not responding at all. He's intimidating him, right? So he's riding the horse and this man is walking behind him and giving him all the bad things in the dictionary you can imagine. I don't want to repeat that, but he's telling him all the bad stuff. So before he comes to the city, he stopped and he went down from his horse. So the man said, now I got him. You know what I'm talking about, right? So sometimes there is someone so good and someone is intimidating them. What is their point? That they get them angry, right? Said, you are not the one who says you are. You are the sheikh, you are the, I got you. Yeah, sometimes this is the whole idea, right? Oh, shaitan, fi shaitan al-ins da, wallahi ajeeb. Iblis yita'allam minnu, yani. Yani, Iblis learn from this guy. Yani, there are people like that. Iblis will say, you're my teacher, man. How do you come up with these ideas? Yeah, so like that. So he insults. So when he thought he got him, he told him, Ya akhi, if you're done, you know, tell me if you're done, because you're not gonna go to the city now. Lots of people they know me, and I don't want them to have jahl on you. Yani, I don't want them to hurt you. You know, because they will, if they listen to you doing this, they are going to hurt you. And I don't want you to be hurt. So I will stand here until you finish. So finish whatever you want. And by the way, what you say is nothing compared to what I know about myself. What I know about myself is way more than that. I am way less than this. Okay? So you can say whatever you want now, and nobody knows. Nobody knows about it. It's between me and you, that's fine. Until you feel comfortable, say it all. But if you go there are some people who will be angry just because you're insulting me, and I don't want them to hurt you, and I don't want you to be hurt. So the man actually asked forgiveness and all of that. So subhanAllah, those stories sound like they are from another world, right? But we actually can all do it by training. So Allah Azza wa Jalla says, اِدْفَعْ بِالَّتِي هِيَ أَحْسَنْ السَّيِّئَةِ. What is going to happen? فَإِذَا الَّذِي بَيْنَكَ وَبَيْنَهُ عَدَاوَةٌ كَأَنَّهُ وَلِيٌّ حَمِيمٌ. You will see that the person whom you have animosity and enmity with, he becomes like someone who's close friend. Even if he does not act like close friend, the way you deal with him is as if he is your close friend. So it goes both ways. يعني don't think that كأنه ولي حميم, يعني he becomes like that. No, it is you treating him like that. That means you still good. You are the one who's praised here. ادفع بالتي هي أحسن السيئة فإذا الذي بينك وبينه عداوة ولي حميم وكأنه ولي حميم كأنه ولي حميم. He's like, you know, a friend. So if you see Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم dealing with the people around him, you think he's dealing with someone who is close friend with him. That is out of the generosity of Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم. It's not out of goodness of these guys. They used to give him all bad things, and Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم is being nice to them, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. وَمَا يُلَقَّاهَا إِلَّا الَّذِينَ صَبَرُوا. May Allah make us among them. صبر. صبر. وَمَا يُلَقَّاهَا إِلَّا ذُو حَظٍ عَظِيمٍ مِنَ الْإِسْلَامِ وَمِنَ الدِّينِ وَمِنَ الْعِلْمِ. حظ, يعني. حظ means a great jid, a great fortune from Allah, a great rizq from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What is that great rizq? Not only the sabr, but you have sabr with ilm. فصبر جميل. Sabr with ilm, sabr with knowledge. You know why you are making the sabr. You know what are you expecting from sabr. You know whom you are doing sabr for, subhanahu wa ta'ala. It's not just passive. It is not passive aggressive. It's not only passive patience. No. It is patience, knowing why you are doing what you're doing. I hope the message is clear, inshallah, Rabbil Alameen. May Allah make us among those who do da'wah for his sake. May Allah make us among those who practice what you say. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us among those who are patient. May Allah make us among those who have knowledge. May Allah Azza wa Jalla make us among those who are always pushing the bad deed with the good deed. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam wa barik ala Sayyidina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam. Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen.